Hello, and welcome to GSA's annual January meeting and sing-along. As you can tell, things are a little different this year, but we will still be entertaining you with the wonderful songs of Gilbert and Sullivan. However, this is also an open board meeting, and there is some business that we need to take care of first. For that, I'll pass the virtual mic on to the Board of Directors President, Libby Weed.
I think we'll all agree that 2020 was a year that, for the most part, we are happy to see in the rearview mirror. But Gilbert and Sullivan Austin flourished in some new ways during this difficult year, so it wasn't all bad news. The biggest downer was that we had no summer grand production and no fall musicale or other live events, but we pivoted and presented digital offerings of previous shows through hashtag DiscoverGSA, and thousands viewed them. We want to thank Leanne Fryer and Matt Marks for these great productions. Also on the downside is that we made the difficult decision to postpone the Mikado yet another year because we could not be sure it would be safe to begin rehearsals in the spring. But we are not standing still. Let me assure you that when the theater is open and we gather again to see this live performance, it will knock your socks off. Some more good news is that we plan to use our greatly reduced grant from the City of Austin, a grant from the Stillwater Foundation, and our reserve funds to create some exciting and innovative GNS scenes with new directors and performers, as well as some familiar faces. So watch for news of these virtual presentations to be live streamed free of charge on YouTube. Adding to the plus side, I'm happy to say that thanks to grants, and memberships and donations from you, our loyal supporters, we remain on firm financial ground. We thank you for your online voting regarding changes to our bylaws and election of our board of directors. The proposed amendments to the bylaws were passed. The newly elected board of directors includes Sue Caldwell, Leanne Fryer, Holton Johnson, Jeanette Jones, Robert Kerr, David Little, Michael Meggs, Diane Radin, Sandra Ragona, Sarah Slaughter, Charles Smeisterla, David Treadwell, Michelle Vanacek, Libby Weed, and Dave Wachowski. This group will meet in the coming week to elect officers and designate roles, as our board is a hardworking group. We express our heartfelt thanks to retiring member Bob Schneider for his years of service on the board. Bob will continue to work with the Wandering Minstrels group. Though 2020 was a difficult year for GSA and everyone else, we believe we made the best of a tough situation, and we're confident of a bright future. We solicit your continued support and participation. Together, we are stronger. Finally, a change in our leadership was announced in our recent newsletter, and that is the transition of our beloved Ralph McPhail Jr. to the role of Artistic Director Emeritus. Rafe's history with us has been monumental, as the following video will demonstrate.
Tonight, we honor one of the most significant figures in the history of Gilbert and Sullivan Austin. Ralph McPhail Jr., whom we affectionately call Rafe, began serving as our artistic director in 2005. He transitioned on January 1st, 2021, to the role of Artistic Director Emeritus, and will continue to be a consultant and a valued member of our association. Professor McPhail is a true giant in our history. The first two decades of the 21st century were a phenomenal period in the history of Gilbert and Sullivan Austin, and much of the credit must go to this remarkable man. Audiences grew with numerous shows playing to packed houses. Many of the finest singers and actors in Central Texas appeared on our stage. Artistic quality and production values grew exponentially with sets, costumes, and technical features drawing rave reviews. Our prestige in the community grew as GSA productions were nominated for and received a wide range of awards. Rafe first directed for us in 1998 and has stage directed all but four of our grand summer productions since that time. He has enjoyed an admirable partnership with music director Jeffrey Jones Ragona, who treasures their years of work together.
Greetings, I'm Jeffrey Jones Ragona, the director of music and principal conductor for Gilbert and Sullivan Austin. And I am here to pay tribute to GNS Austin's artistic director, now emeritus artistic director, Ralph McPhail Jr., affectionately known to us here in Austin as Rafe. When Rafe first came to us in 1998, I was told that he was North America's leading expert on Gilbert and Sullivan, something that instantly terrified me, as I was convinced that I was about to be exposed as the fraud I was. Instead, Rafe turned out to be very kind, very professional, very congenial, and supportive. He was also very knowledgeable of the music. This is something that is not always the case when a music director and stage director collaborate. In fact, stereotypically, the relationship is contentious. But Rafe and I never had a cross word or a disagreement with each other. He was always very good about telling me what was going to be going on stage so I could better prepare the actors and the orchestra for what we would be doing, and was was definitely far more knowledgeable about music than he ever gave himself credit for. He would often say that he had no ear and he had no understanding of music, and I just want everyone to know that's simply not the case. He may not have possessed the training that I or any other conductor would have, but he has an ear, and he knows good music, and he knows how important it is, and he loves to hear it. I know that your next adventures are going to be very grand, and I look forward to the day when we may once again all gather in theaters, and Rafe is here as our honored guest and our emeritus director, a title well-earned, emeritus meaning worthy of honor or deserving of merit, and Mr. McPhail is all of those things. Rafe, I thank you for the friendship, the collaboration, the support, and the education that I have gained over the last 2+ decades.
Rafe and Jeffrey have worked closely with production manager Bill Hatcher and stage manager Monica Kurtz for the majority of these shows. All four of these individuals have been named to our Hall of Fame, and what a team these professionals have been. Rafe has directed some of Austin's finest actors and singers, and they recall the experience of working with this unique director.
Rafe McPhail. What can I say about this wonderful man that hasn't already been said? He holds a very special place in my heart for the 20 years I've been in Austin. The very first production I did with him was The Sorcerer in 2001, and 18 productions later, my feelings for him have only grown. To me, he has always been an impassioned, exciting, and thoroughly thoughtful director. No one knows more about the works of Gilbert and Sullivan than he, and he has taught me more than he will ever know. He certainly changed my knowledge of directing and the art of blocking. I promise to always lead with my downstage a leg. He's always been willing to collaborate with me on my characters and give me leeway if I feel passionate about something. Be willing to trust me, in other words, something other directors are either unwilling or unable to do. The awards I've been fortunate to win or been nominated for, I give all credit to Rafe. I truly believe that if not for him, these accolades would never have happened. There are far too many stories for me to pick just one or two, and I'd be here all night if I tried. I wish him and his lovely wife all the best in Bridgewater, and I hope he will always feel the desire to keep in touch with those who have loved and respected him for so long, myself included. To Rafe, all I can say is a simple thank you for all you've taught me. and others, and all you've done for the society.
Long before Professor MacPhail began working with us in Austin, he was renowned as a GNS scholar. During his tenure as professor and director of theater at Bridgewater College in Virginia, he directed Savoy operas both there and on many other stages. He has authored numerous reviews and papers and has made presentations at many symposia and conferences, including the Metropolitan Museum of Art in New York. His leadership in the worldwide GNS community is legendary. During his lifelong scholarly endeavors, Rafe had the opportunity to study many original documents, including the prompt books of W.S. Gilbert and those of the Doily Cart Opera Company. He knew in great detail how Gilbert himself had staged his productions, understood the significance of the minutiae, and dedicated himself to directing productions in the authentic style of the originals. Gilbert and Sullivan Austin has benefited immensely from our association with this remarkable scholar and artist. He is a courtly gentleman, a congenial correspondent, a fascinating raconteur, and a warm-hearted friend. We look back in pleasure at his many directing triumphs, all of which brought honor and glory to Gilbert and Sullivan Austin. Tonight, we honor Ralph MacPhail Jr. and express our heartfelt thanks for his years of service and influence. When we are able to gather in performance spaces again, we look forward to having Rafe and his dear wife Alice back in their seats to enjoy the next production. Ladies and gentlemen, please join me in honoring Mr. Ralph MacPhail Jr.
Rafe has contributed so much to GSA over the years, and his new project for 2021 is collecting his Austin program notes and newsletter articles into a book. GSA supports this wider dissemination of Rafe's writings and hopes that many Savoyards will want to add this collection to their libraries. Now that the business has concluded, it's time to get to the entertainment. We've got a great lineup of singers who have provided pre-recorded performances. One of the advantages of being virtual is we are able to feature people who don't live in Austin anymore. Some are spread across the US, and one is currently in Germany. You're still encouraged to sing along, just in the comfort of your own home. Songs with choruses will have the chorus lyrics printed on the screen just in time to join in. If you haven't done so already, you can click the link in our video description to view our program. Let's kick it off with a song from our next grand production, The Mikado.
Wandering minstrel, I, a thing of shreds and patches, of ballad songs and snatches, and dreamy lullaby. My catalogue is long, through every passion ranging, and to your humours changing, I tune my supple song. I tune my supple song. Are you in sentimental mood? I'll sigh with you. Oh, coldness, do you brood? I'll do so too. Oh, sorrow, sorrow. tomorrow. I'll charm your willing ears with songs of lovers' fears. With sympathetic tears, my cheeks bid you. Patriotic sentiment is wanted. I've patriotic ballads cut and dried. For where'er our country's banner may be planted, all other local banners are defied. Our warriors in serried ranks assemble. Never fear, nor they conceal it if they do. And I shouldn't be surprised if nations tremble before the mighty troops, the troops of Tiddy-Woo. And if you call for a song of the sea, I'll heave the capstan round. With a yo-heave-ho where the wind is lee, her anchor's a trip and her helm's a lee, hurrah for the homeward bound. To lay aloft in a landsman breeze may tickle a landsman's taste, but the happiest hour a sailor sees is when he's down at an inland town with his Nancy on his knees. Yo-ho! And his arm around her waist. A wandering minstrel I, a thing of shreds and patches, of ballad songs and snatches, and dreamy lullaby, and dreamy lullaby,
tear and long drawn song. Cheerily carols the lark over the cot. Merrily whistles the clerk, scratching a blot. But the lark and the clerk, I remark, comfort me not. Oh. Over the ripening peach buzzes the bee. Splash on the billowy beach tumbles the sea. But the peach and the beach, they are each nothing to me. And why, who am I, daft Madge, crazy Meg, mad Margaret, poor pig? Mad, hi, yes, very, but why, Miss Steady, don't call. No crime, tis only that I'm love lonely, that's all. To a garden full of posies cometh one to gather flowers, and he wanders through its bowers, toying with the wanton roses, the wanton roses, who uprising from their beds hold up high their shameless heads, with their pretty lips a-pouting, with their pretty lips a-pouting, never doubting, never doubting that for Scythian roses he would gather aught but roses. In a nest of weeds and nettles lay a violet hath hidden, hoping that his glance unbidden yet might fall upon her petals, upon her petals. Though she's lived alone apart, hopefully nestling at her heart. But alas, the cruel awaking, but alas, the cruel awaking, set her little heart a-breaking, for he gathered for his posies only roses, only roses.
Tempted sea, repent not, mocking maid, thy girlish choice. The fervor of my love affects my voice. A tenor all singers above, this doesn't edge of a question. Should keep himself quiet, attend to his diet, and carefully nurse his digestion. But when he is madly in love, it's certain to tell on his singing. You can't do chromatics with proper emphatics when anguish your bosom is ringing. When distracted with worries in plenty, and his fault is 120, and his sensitive palate as dry as a crust is, a tenor can't do himself justice. Now observe. Ah, you see, I can't do myself justice. Sing if my fervor were mock. It's easy enough if you're acting, but when one's emotion is born of devotion, you mustn't be over-exacting. Why not to be firm as a rock, to venture a shaking vibrato? When fervor's expected, be calm and connected, or never attempt agitato. But of course, when his tongue is of leather, and his lips appear pasted together, and his sensitive palate as dry as a crust is, a tenor can't do himself justice. Now observe. I can't do myself justice.
I cannot tell what this love may be that cometh to and not to be. It cannot be kind as they'd imply, or why do they sigh? It cannot be joy and rapture deep, or why do these gentle ladies weep? It cannot be bliss or misty sad. Oh, why are their eyes so wondrous red? For everywhere true love I see, a coming to all but not to me. I cannot tell how this love may be. And sigh.
is a plaintive song, sung by a suffering maid, telling a tale of wrong, telling of hope betrayed, tuned to its changing note, sorry when he is sad, blind to his every mout, merry when he is glad, love that no wrong can cure, love that is always new, that is the love that's pure, that is the love that's true, love that no wrong can cure, love that is always new, that is the love that's pure. Rendering good for ill, smiling at every frown, yielding your own safe will, laughing your teardrops down, never a selfish whim, trouble or pain to stir, everything when sets the sun, dark is the night. light from the empty waste of waters. Sad is the eye when sets the sun, dark is the night to wears for daughters. Heavy the sorrow that bows the head, when love is
such a lovely song. Don't worry, we've still got plenty of singers left. I just wanted to pop in to give a little bit of context for our next piece. Iolanthe, which was the first show to premiere at the Savoy Theater. I learned that from our day at the Savoy production in March. Originally contained an additional song for Mount Ararat, entitled De Belleville was regarded as the Crichton of his age. It wasn't finished by the premiere, and the first night it was recited rather than sung. Due to negative response from critics, the song was cut soon after the opening. Since then, the score has been lost, though a violin part was discovered in 2000. But it is not enough to reconstruct the original melody. However, the original lyrics remain. Grammy award-winning record producer and composer, Thomas Z. Shepard, who is passionate about G&S, set Gilbert's lyrics to new music, which to me sounds like it would have fit right in with the original production. This performance is audio only, so I've added photos of Mount Ararat from our 2019 production of Iolanthe, performed by the talented Sam Johnson. Please enjoy this GSA premiere, as well as the rest of our program.
Belleville was regarded as the Crichton of his age. His tragedies were reckoned much too thoughtful for the stage. His poems held a noble rank, although it's very true that being very proper, they were read by very few. He was a famous painter too, and shone upon the line, and even Mr. Ruskin came and worshipped at his shrine. But alas, the school he followed was heroically high, the kind of art men rave about, but very seldom buy. And everybody said, how can he be repaid? This very great, this very good, this very gifted man. But nobody could hit upon a practicable plan. He was a great inventor and discovered all alone a plan for making everybody's fortune but his own. For in business, an inventor's little better than a fool, and my highly gifted friend was no exception to the rule. His poems, people read 'em in the sixpenny reviews. His pictures, they engraved 'em in the illustrated news. His inventions, they perhaps might have enriched him by degrees, but all his little income went in patent office fees. And everybody said, how can he be repaid? This very great, this very good, this very gifted man. But nobody could hit upon a practicable plan. The point was given up in absolute despair, when a distant cousin died and he became a millionaire, with a county seat in Parliament, a moor or two of grouse, and a taste for making inconvenient speeches in the House. Then government conferred on him the highest of awards. They took him from the Commons and they put him in the Lords. And who's so fit to sit in it? Deny it if you can. Then this very great, this very good, this very gifted man. Though I'm more than half afraid that it sometimes might be said that we never should have reveled in that source of proper pride. However great his merits, if his cousin hadn't died.
There was a time forever gone. Oh, woe is me. It was no crime to love but thee alone. Oh, woe is me. One heart, one life, one soul, one aim, one goal. Each in the other's thrall, each all in all. Ah, woe is me.
way to the cheating world go you. Where pirates all are well to do, but I'll be true to the song I sing, and live and die a pirate king. For I am a pirate king, and it is a glorious thing to be a pirate king, for I am a pirate king, and it is a glorious thing to be a pirate king. When I sally forth to seek my prey, I have myself in a royal way. I sink a few more ships, it's true, than a well-bred monarch ought to do. But many a king on a first-class throne, if he wants to call his crown his own, must manage somehow to get through a more dirty work than ever I do. For I am a pirate king, and it is a glorious thing to be a pirate king, for I am a pirate king.
If you will cast your eyes on me, however plain you be,
all for joining us for this different but still fun sing-along. Traditionally, at the conclusion of every musicale, everyone together sings Hail Poetry and Now to the Banquet We Press. Unfortunately, we don't have a banquet to press on to, so we will be omitting that song so it can be sung the next time we are all together. We do still have Hail Poetry for you. If you haven't done so already, click the link in our video description to view the sheet music for Hail Poetry, though I'm sure many of you have it memorized by now. Before we end the program, I would like to thank some people. Special thanks goes to Gene Sasaki, who worked with most of the singers, via Zoom, to provide them with audio tracks to sing to. And thanks to Libby Weed and Matt Marks for writing and producing the beautiful tribute to Rafe. Matt is also the one streaming our broadcast, just like he does for hashtag DiscoverGSA watch parties. Speaking of, this month we will be streaming the 2014 production of HMS Pinafore, which will premiere this Friday, January 15th at 7:30 p.m. We actually showed this production way back in May as our very first hashtag Discover GSA offering, But since many people hadn't discovered us yet, we wanted to show it again so that those who missed it the first time could enjoy this wonderful production. So, without further ado, hail poetry!
Tree.